Knot Divided. That's a 12-foot tall snow sculpture. And we did that in Breckenridge, Colorado. So here is a Möbius band that makes three twists. Okay. By itself, you know, we don't care about the shape. The Möbius band by itself is really no different to a mathematician than the rubber band. It's just a loop. Okay? We're not looking at the cross section and whether it's twisted or not. It's just we're looking at the center line of the knot that defines the knot. But once you take the Möbius band and you split it down the middle, it becomes a knot. Now it happens to be a trefoil knot. Because now if you had these strands being nice and soft, you could move them around and they would be interlinked in exactly the same way as this copper structure. If it's only singly twisted, it will simply open up in a loop that's twice the size and actually has a full twist in it. So it depends on how much twisted it is. If the Möbius band is even more twisted, like five times, you may get this other knot that we had labeled as 5 sub 1 or something like that, which, you know, gives an ever more coiling of that same thing. We started out with a trefoil knot now, and so here is roughly a trefoil knot, okay? And then we split this trefoil knot down the middle because it happens in this trefoil knot to be of a Möbius structure. So let me back up a little bit and show you two different trefoils. They're two artistic trefoil knots. I kind of call them like, you know, trefoil standing on its own 2 feet, because they were carefully designed so that, you know, I can actually sort of stand them up. They're not going to topple over. Can you see a difference? Well, I'm claiming one of them is a Möbius band and the other one is not. Let's figure out, you know, whether this one is twisted. So I'm starting on the side towards the camera up on the lobe here, and I'm running my finger slowly down here. I get to the underside of this foot. I'm coming to the front here. I'm getting around, I'm staying here on the upper side of that foot, I'm coming up here, and I'm back to where I started.
Still so on my side.
On the same side, so this one is double-sided. Okay, I could paint the side green, and I could paint the other one red, and everything would be fine. But now let's compare that to the other Möbius band. If I'm starting here again, on your side, I'm moving down here, I'm getting to the bottom of this foot, I'm on the bottom of this highly curved little thingy. I'm going through the middle, staying at the bottom here, staying at the bottom side, coming around, being at the bottom of this foot. Now I'm coming up the back side. And so basically I'm coming up to the back side and I've gotten to the other side. If I continue, again, sliding down here, being on the upper side, sliding over on the upper side here, coming back, and I'm coming back to where I started, but I had to go around the loop twice.
So that's Möbius.
And in that process, I would have painted everything green, right? And there's no way I can paint one or the other side without the two colors running into one another at some point. This is the idea of a Möbius trefoil knot. And then we took a slightly different shape of, again, you can see this looks roughly like a trefoil knot, except it started out with a cross section that was more or less, you know, rectangular originally, but then we carved out the middle part to make essentially a split. And because it's a Möbius band, when I do this, I get a knot that is not really divided. That's why we call it knot divided. It's like a roller coaster where if you start on this side of the big lobe and you go around the whole roller coaster, by the time you come the first time back up on the mountain, you actually are on the other side. And then you have to go once through more through the roller coaster until you come back to where you started. So it's just one long string, you know, essentially tied together. And while when it was still fused without the gap in the middle, it was a trefoil knot, now it's a much more complicated knot. How many crossings does this thing have? Actually, not that easy to see, but I was amazed at MSRI, you know, like a 7-year-old kid, and I showed them that, and within seconds, he said 12. And he realized wherever we had a crossing in our trefoil knot, we now had split it. We now get 4 crossings. We have this situation. And so, indeed, he's right. You know, now we have 3 times 4 crossings. It's a 12-crossing knot. So by the time you're kind of looking through the knot table, you're already, you know, very far down there where there are thousands of different knots, right? And that's just one of them.
Are roller coasters knots?
I'm pretty sure that some of them are, because, I mean, that makes kind of fun, you know, you want to Many of them have sort of these like figure eight configuration. They go sometimes around the loop and then they go through the figure eight. By the time you go a couple of times through the middle with figure eight, it is very likely that the things are knotted. But you can never be quite sure. There are some very complicated looking knots that you can find on the internet, like when you look for something like difficult unknot or difficult trivial knot. They show you a knot that you swear this is a real knot, but actually it's not.
Experimental part of DNA topology. So the field is called DNA topology. We study geometry and topology of circular DNA molecules or linear DNA molecules that locally behave as circles.
Same with this one, except it goes back. So it starts at the front, curls back, hold it on the way down. Now you're going to take this lace, put it under that loop,